So good morning to all. Myself, Dr. Mangat Singh. I am working as assistant professor in the Department of Science and Technology, Faculty of Education and Methodology, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. So today we will discuss about some basics about the chemical kinetics. So our main motive is why is the need of chemical kinetics and what is the role of chemical kinetics in studying the chemical reactions. So our topic is chemical kinetics. So first of all, I will discuss why is the need of chemical kinetics, why we study this particular field of chemistry. So as we know, in thermodynamics, we will talk about the equilibrium constants. So first I will define, for example, a chemical reactions A plus B is proceeded to form a product C plus D. So here, so according to thermodynamics, we will tell about the reactions based on the equilibrium constant. For example, for these reactions, if we tell about the extent of reactions, so I will tell based on the equilibrium constant. For this reaction, the equilibrium constants, if I define K equilibrium, is the concentration of reactants, sorry, products, concentration of products upon me concentration of reactants. So based on this, we will define K equilibrium is equal to concentration of C upon me and concentration of D upon concentration of A and concentration B. So this is defined over the K equilibrium. So now based on the K equilibrium, we define the extent of reactions. So if K is large, for example, if K equilibrium is large, we tell the reaction is more towards the forward direction. And if K is less, then we tell that the reaction is in backward directions, or we say that there is the extent of reaction is very less compared to when K is large. So from this conclusion, we cannot tell about the reactions for a particular time of period. So we generally tell about the extent of reactions based on the K equilibrium. So as we know, if the reaction is spontaneous, there must be a delta G negative. For a spontaneous reaction, the delta G must be negative. So all these things we discuss in the thermodynamics. But if we tell about for a particular time period, how much the reaction is converted, the A and B converted into the product C and D. So for this, we have to deal with the chemical kinetics. So we deal with the chemical kinetic. So as per this, chemical kinetics. So there are chemical kinetics generally we study three type of reactions in chemical kinetics. First, the reactions which are very fast, so we define them fast reactions. Secondly, we are define the slow moderate reactions, and third part is we define the slow reactions. So in chemical kinetics, we generally deals with the three type of reactions, or we can say these reactions are divided into three different parts, fast reactions, moderate reactions, and slow reactions. So fast reactions are those which instantaneously converted into the product. Similarly, moderate reactions having rate of reaction is very slow, moderate, and slow reactions are those which are having rate of reaction is very slow. In case of fast reaction, for example, if we tell about sodium chloride plus AgNO3, so we get AgCl precipitates instantaneously. So we can tell about this reaction is the fast type of reaction. Similarly, if we tell about the slow reactions, for example, rusting of iron, similarly, formation of formation of diamond. So all these type of reactions are slow reactions, and this type of reactions are flow reactions. So there is a second, third class which we define the moderate type of reactions. Moderate type of reactions in which we, for example, if we react, for example, the formation of water from H2O2. Similarly, formation of ammonia from hydrogen and nitrogen. So these type of reactions comes in the moderate category. So in chemical kinetics, we generally discuss all three type of reactions. So, generally the slow reactions we will not tell about the rate of the reactions, and similarly the fast reactions is very difficult to define their reaction rate. So generally we discuss only moderate type of reactions which we can tell about their rate of reaction. So for rate of reactions, in case of fast reactions, which having rate of reaction is very fast, they generally instantly converted into the product. If we tell about the, if form a graph between the reactant concentration and time. This type of graph we generally see in case of fast reaction. Similarly, in case of moderate type of reactions, we see this type of graph we see in case of a moderate type of reaction. These type of graphs are seen in fast reactions, and this type of graphs we will see in the moderate type of reactions. This type with respect to reactant, and this type with respect to the product concentration. So now the terminology comes, how we can calculate the rate of reactions and what is the rate of reactions. So these will how will you calculate the rate of reaction? So what is what is the rate of a reaction? So generally rate of reaction is defined, rate of reaction is defined the directly proportional to the concentration, concentration of reacting species. For example, a reaction A plus B converted into the product C and D. So for this type of reactions, we generally define rate is directly proportional to concentration of reactant A and concentration of B. Or we can say the rate is the change in concentration, change in concentration of reactant with respect to time, change in time. So this will define the rate of reaction with respect to reactant. Likewise, we can define the rate of reaction with respect to product, change in concentration of product divided upon me change in time. So this will tell us about the rate of reaction. So now there are two types of reaction rate we define. First is the instantaneous rate, second is the average rate of reactions. So what is the difference between the instantaneous rate and the average rate of a reaction? So average rate of a reactions, when we tell about the average rate of reactions, for example, concentration of reactant and time. So this will be the graph. So if we tell about the average rate of reactions, we consider the two points, for example, this point and this point with respect to time. So here is, I can say C1, C2, T1 and T2. So for average rate of reaction, average rate of reaction इज इक्वल टू चेंज इन कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट. चेंज इन कंसंट्रेशन यानी कि सी टू माइनस सी वन अपॉन में टी टू माइनस टी वन. सो बाई दिस वे वी कैन डिफाइन द एवरेज रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन. सो नाउ इफ वी टेल अबाउट द इंस्टेंटेनियस रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन, reactions. So instantaneous rate is defined the time when for a particular time of period when we define the rate of reaction. This will average rate of reaction defined between a time interval. For example, 5 to 10 minutes and 10 to 20 minutes. But instantaneous time for a particular time. For this type of reactions, if we tell about the instantaneous rate of reaction, for example, if we tell about the instantaneous rate of reaction for this type of graph, we just consider a small portion of the change in concentration of reactant with respect to change in concentration with time for a small portion of time interval. So for this type of we define change in concentration, yani if we tell about the reactant concentration, change in concentration, that is small change. For small change we use the term d. So small change, change in concentration with respect to small interval of time, this will defines the rate of the reactions. Here we use the symbol negative, indicates the decrease in concentration of the reactant. So likewise, in case of with respect to product, we define for a reaction d. For this will define the instantaneous rate with respect to reactant, and this will define the rate of reaction with respect to products. So this is the basic difference between the average rate and instantaneous rate. So now next we will tell about the what is the order of reaction and molecularity of the reactions. So what is the order of reaction molecularity of a reaction, and third one is the rate law expression. So first I will tell about the molecularity of a reactions. What is the molecularity of reactions? For example, a reaction A plus B is going to form a product C plus D. So in this case, and there are two reacting species which are going to convert into the product C and D. So in this case, we can tell about the molecularity of the reaction is equal to 2. Molecularity is equal to 2 because the reacting species, are 2. But it is not necessary. There is the molecularity of the reaction is 2 because based on the contribution of reactant A and B is not directly linked with the molecularity of the reactions. Because for example, if we consider a reaction A plus B plus C plus D is going to product P plus Q plus R plus S. So in this type of reactions, we cannot show the reacting species are 4 and the molecularity of the reaction is 4 because the molecularity of a reaction is not more than 3 in chemical reaction, because there is another theory, Cruzan theory, which will tell about the why the molecularity of the reaction is not more than 3. But in this case, we are defined the molecularity of the 3 for this type of reaction is 2 because the reacting species we are considering both A and B are equally contributing in forming the product C and D. But in this case, we are if the reacting species are 4 and we are giving the product PQRS like that, so we cannot tell about the molecularity of the reaction is 4 because there is a very less possibility the contribution of each reacting species equally in forming the product. So next we tell about the order of a reaction. Order of a reaction. 15. So now the order of reactions. So for a, the order of a reaction is the power, sum of the powers in case of order. For example, first of all, a reaction A is going to form a product C plus B. So this type of reactions, we tell about the order of a reactions. If we calculate the order of reactions, so rate expression for this type of reaction is defined as some constant into me concentration of A and concentration of B. So generally the order of reaction is equal to kya hota hai, sum of powers of exponents of reacting species, of reacting species. Here are the two reacting species A and B, and the powers of their sum of their exponents of their reacting species. So here we consider 1 and 1 because both A and B are equally contributing in forming the product C and C. So C and D. So in this case we can say that the order of the reaction sum of powers 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. For a general reactions, if we consider the exponents A, B, C and D for this type of reaction. So in this case, if we define the order of reaction in terms of rate expression is equal to A sum powers or B sum powers. So in this case, if we consider A and B are arbitrary exponents, so in such, in this type of reactions, we define the order of reaction is the sum of exponents A and B. So this will be define the order of that particular reactions. So next we will discuss about the rate law expression and how it how by this way we can how we calculate the order of a given reactions, and we can define the rate expression, and we can calculate the rate of that particular reaction at a particular instant of time. Thanks you, goodbye, and see you.